Hello, Internet! So nice to see you! One of my favorite music theory tricks to create interesting chord progression and interesting musical effect is the pedal point. A pedal point is one note or more notes held or repeated over a chord progression. In other words, you just choose one note, then you play the same note, and every time the chord changes, you either hold this note or repeat, so play again this note. And of course, since the note is the same but the chord is changing, the very same note will acquire a different meaning with every changing chord. Now, pedal points are not a new idea. They were already well known at the time of Bach. And in fact, the very name pedal point comes from that time. If you ever played a church organ, you know that there are one or more keyboards for your hands called manuals, and then there can be a keyboard for your feet called a pedal. The pedals controls the super low note of the organ, and indeed what the pedal point was at the time was to hold the low note in the organ and change the chord on top. But of course, we're not restricted to do this with a low note. We can also do it with a high note or a middle note, as we'll see later. Now, pedal points are used literally in all styles of music, and I really mean all styles of music. So why don't we see a few examples of songs that use pedal points in different styles? Probably the most famous example of a pedal point in rock and roll music is Jump by Van Halen. You can hear how the synth is playing both the main riff and it holds a low note, which is our pedal point. Let's see a completely different example from a completely different style. Hear that. How's that for a change in style? The song is I'm Blue from the Italian band Eiffel 65. In this case, I want to comment exactly on how the pedal point is used in the song, because it's a very intelligent application of a pedal point. You see, the very first time we hear the chorus in this song, we have a pedal note. The bass is holding the root note of the key, and we hear the chorus over this static background that is the root note of the key. Since the melody cannot move away from this root note because the root note is held throughout, this builds expectation. You want this melody to get unchained from the root note and get into its more natural chord progression. Then, just after that, we hear the chorus without the pedal. Now the chord progression is not nailed down to the root note anymore, and now the whole music feels a lot more exciting. Before we move ahead, I want to remark that since pedal points are used very commonly in music, I can't possibly review all the songs that use pedal points. So what I'm showing here are just examples, and of course, if you have more examples of songs that use pedal points, feel free to write them down in the comments. Here's another example in a heavy metal style. This is the intro of Another Thing Coming by the band Judas Priest. As you can hear, the bass is playing the same note over and over, while the guitar plays different power chords, and the contrast between this changing power chord and this fixed bass create an expectation. This kind of expectation is great if you use it in an intro, or like we were seeing in the example before, the first time you hear a chorus, to create more expectation for when the song proper comes in. The pedal point has been a favorite of all kind of composers for film music. Here I want to pick a somewhat old example. This is a song from the band Goblin that has been used for George Romero's Dawn of the Dead movie. Since the movie was cut and recut and published in many different versions, this song does not appear in all versions of the movie. Anyway, hear how the bass hold the same note here and the chords on top of this bass change and create interesting contrasts. Now at this time, many of you may expect me to put a jazz example. Well, I'm not gonna do this right now because I've noticed that every time I put a jazz song in my videos, the viewership drops down suddenly. It seems like you guys on YouTube don't want to hear jazz examples. So I'm listening to you and this time I'm not going to put a jazz example. If you are outraged at the lack of jazz in this video, then go and give a like to all my other videos featuring jazz examples, and so I will get the message and next time you will get your jazz example. The next example comes from the opening of the anime Ghost in the Shell. The song is Inner Universe by Yoko Kanno. Hear how the bass is holding the root note again, and then at a certain point, the bass stops holding that note and follows the chord progression, creating a difference in the energy of the song. So far, all the examples have seen hold the pedal point in the bass note, meaning that the lowest note is held and the chord change above that held note. But a pedal point does not need to be on the bass note. One of the most classical and definitely one of my favorite examples of a pedal point that is in between and not the highest, not the lowest note, it's this piece by Franz Liszt. Notice how you have three layers of music here. You have the accompaniment in the left hand, you have the arpeggio on the right hand, and you have the pedal point that starts the melody in between the accompaniment and the arpeggio. Remark how the same note feels completely different whenever the chord change. As an exercise to you, it would be a good idea to listen again to that example, check the score and see what exactly is the chord progression so that you can see how the same note has different functions over the changing chord progression. So with the Liszt example, we have seen now a pedal point that is not in the bass, but it's in the melody of the song, meaning that the part that you hear as the melody start with a fixed note over changing chords. At this point, naturally, you may have a question. Is it possible to create a pedal point that it's not in the bass note and it's not either in the melody of the song? That is it possible to create a pedal point that is in the accompaniment but not in the bass note? Yes, it is perfectly possible, and in fact it's done very commonly. So here's another example, and this time again the pedal point is not in the melody and it's not in the bass. And you could have it all, my empire of dirt. I will let you down, I will make you hurt. If I could start again. This is Johnny Cash cover of Hurt by Nine Inch Nails. Listen to that piano note that gets repeated every chord. That note is the same every time. It is a pedal point, it doesn't change, but it does sound different because the chord is changing. Having that same note played over and over while both the chords and the melody of the song change around it, gives this feeling in this song of having something in your life that cannot be changed and that will always stay the same regardless of what happened and regardless of what you do. This feeling can be used to create hopeful feelings or desperate feelings like in this song. Pedal point, it's a very powerful musical device. And even if it's been used very commonly from the time of Bach to today, there are still lots of possibilities to use it, and every time it's used, it really gives something special to the song. Now, the effective use of pedal point in your music, though, depends on having a great chord progression to play it over. Meaning that if you play a pedal point but the chord progression is poor, the pedal point will not really work that well. A pedal point will give its emotional payoff only if played over a great chord progression. So it's important that you learn how to write great chord progression for your music. For this, I suggest you take a look at my course Complete Chord Mastery. Complete Chord Mastery is not a book. It's a complete video course studied specifically to teach guitar players everything they need to know about chords and harmony on guitar. All the theory is done straight on the fretboard. We don't do piano examples, and all the examples are transcribed in both standard notation and tablature. So you can learn how to apply every concept you learn immediately to your instrument and to your own music in real time. If you're tired of learning theory that you cannot apply and you want to get better at writing your own music, you definitely want to check out Complete Chord Mastery. So if you have a minute, just click on the link on the top right and go and check it out. If you like these videos, smash on that like button and don't forget to subscribe and click on notification, otherwise YouTube will not let you know when I put up a new video. And if you have any comments, write them down. If you have any feedback, write them in the comments. If you have any suggestion for future videos, write it in the comment. I love to hear from you guys and I always read my comments. This is Tommaso Zillio on musicteoryforguitar.com, and until next time, enjoy.